हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज पुरुषोत्तम विश्वकर्मा। हियर इन दिस वीडियो वी विल टॉक अबाउट द थर्ड चैप्टर इन योर इंग्लिश फ्लेमिंगो बुक डीप वाटर। दिस ईयर योर सिलेबस हैज बीन रिड्यूस्ड बट यू हैव टू स्टडी दिस चैप्टर डीप वाटर। सो व्हाट इज डीप वाटर? This is written by William O. Douglas. And whenever this word is discussed, and whenever this word comes to your mind, it has another word attached to it. Water hydrophobia. Many of the people are afraid. They fear water. Most of us don't know how to swim. It's not an easy task. But once you have resolved, once you are determined, you will be able to do anything. In this chapter, we'll talk about the fear of William O. Douglas, William Orville Douglas, along with his determination, his desire, his resolution, how he overcame his fear. So let's see, first of all, about the author. About the author, William Douglas, born in 1898 and died in 1980, was born in Maine, Minnesota. An American writer, William Orville Douglas, after graduating with a Bachelor of Arts in English, he graduated himself in English. He completed his BA, Bachelor of Arts in English and Economics. He spent 2 years teaching high school in Yakima. Yakima is the place in USA. Actually, Yakima is a river, a tributary river of Columbia River. After graduating with Bachelor of Arts in English and Economics, he spent 2 years teaching high school in Yakima. Further, he decided not to pursue this career. He left it. However, he got tired of this and decided to pursue a legal career. Wanted to be a judge, a lawyer. He met Franklin D. Roosevelt, the president of USA, at Yale, and became an advisor and friend to the president. Then after he became an advisor and friend to the president, Franklin D. Roosevelt. Douglas was a leading advocate of individual rights. He became a leading advocate of individual rights. He retired in the year 1975 with a term lasting 36 years. How long? He was a judge for 36 years. And this is a record. And remains the longest serving justice in the history of the court. So this is a record in the history of the court. William Orville Douglas remained the longest serving judge. How many years? For 36 years. Justice in the history of the court. The following excerpt is taken from Of Men and Mountains. This excerpt is taken from his writing Of Men and Mountains. By William O. Douglas, William Orville Douglas. It reveals how as a young boy, William Douglas nearly drowned in a swimming pool. In this story, in this chapter, in this narrative, we'll study how William O. Douglas, William Orville Douglas, experienced the drowning in a swimming pool. In this essay, he talks about his fear of water, his hydrophobia, and thereafter, how he finally overcame it. How he finally overcame his fear of water. Notice how the autobiographical part of the selection is used to support his discussion of fear. So in this video, in this chapter, you have to notice how it can be used. How this part of your experience can be used for discussion of fear. If you have any such experience, any drowning experience, do remember to tell me in comment section. share with your friends. Let's start the line by line explanation. It had happened when I was 10 or 11 years old. William O. Douglas starts his journey when he was merely 10 or 11 years old. He starts narrating his story. Who had decided to learn to swim? William or Willie Douglas decided to learn to swim. There was a pool at the YMCA, Young Men's Christian Association. At the YMCA, Young Men's Christian Association, there was a pool in Yakima. At that place, Yakima is also a river, that offered exactly the opportunity. It was exact place, a favorable place for him to learn how to swim. The Yakima River was treacherous, fearsome. The river was treacherous. Mother continually warned against it and kept fresh in my mind the details of each drowning in the river. My mother used to always reminded me that there are many who had been drowned in this river. So you need to be very careful. Don't go there. The Yakima River was treacherous. Mother continually warned against it and kept fresh in my mind the details of each drowning in the river. But the YMCA pool was safe. It was only 2 or 3 feet deep. At one end, the depth was only 2 feet, 2 to 3 feet. At the another, that is deep end, it was 9 feet. But the slope was gradual. The steep was gradual. And while it was 9 feet, at the other, the drop was gradual. This drop was gradual. Here it was only 2 feet, and here it was 9 feet deep. I got a pair of water wings and went to the pool. He went to the pool, having water wings, a safety wing for learning swimming. He went to the pool. I hated to walk naked into it. Although he hated to walk naked into water, and so my skinny legs, I didn't want to show his skinny legs, but I subdued my pride and did it. Subdued, forgot, calmed my pride and did it. I forgot my pride and did it without thinking of my pride, of my legs. I entered into the swimming pool. Who entered into the swimming pool? William or Willie Douglas. From the beginning, however, I had an aversion. Aversion means a strong dislike. I had an aversion to the water when I was in it. I did not like water. This started when I was 3 or 4 years old. I had an aversion since my childhood. Who is telling us? William or Willie Douglas had an aversion since his childhood. This started when I was 3 or 4 years old, and father took me to the beach in California. My father took me to the beach in California. He accompanied his father to the beach of California. He and I, that means his father and William Orville Douglas, went to the beach. We stood together in the surf waves. I hung onto him, watching the waves, seeing the waves. The child was afraid. He hung his father. He clinged to his father. Yet the waves knocked me down. But the waves knocked him down. He was down to water and swept over me. And water swept over me. He was covered. He was enveloped by water. I was buried in water. So he was covered in water. My breath was gone. William Orville Douglas is telling us his breath was gone. He was unable to breathe. I was frightened. He tells us he was frightened. Father laughed. Seeing my situation, father laughed, and that was terrible for me. But there was terror in my heart at the overpowering force of the waves. Although father was laughing, but I was terrified seeing the force of waves. So this was the very first experience by William Orville Douglas when he was 3 or 4 years old. Since then, he had an aversion to the water. Next paragraph. My introduction to the YMCA swimming pool revived unpleasant memories when I was introduced to this pool, Young Men's Christian Association. This reminded me those unpleasant memories of the past when I was 3 or 4 years old, and it stirred in me those childish fear of water. But in a little while, I gathered confidence. But soon I gathered my confidence. I tried swimming with my new water wings, that safety wings. Watching the other boys and trying to learn by aping them. It's very easy. The easiest way to learn is aping, copying. Copying is very easy thing, and to learn new things. So I was, William Orville Douglas was also learning swimming by copying them, those boys who were learning swimming in the pool. I did this for 2 or 3 times on different days and was just beginning to feel at ease in the water. I was feeling comfortable in water when the misadventure, just after that, there was a misadventure, bad episode in the life of William Orville Douglas that changed his mind. He was resolute to learn to swim. But what happened? What was the thing that happened that changed his mind? Let's see what actually happened on that day. I went to the pool when no one else was there. Who went to the pool? I went to the pool when no one else was there. William Orville Douglas went to the pool when no one else was there. He was all alone when he went to the pool that day. The place was quiet. No one else was there. That is why the place was quiet. The water was still. Water was still because there was no movement. Floor, the bottom of the pool was tiled, having tiles, and was as white as clean, like a bathtub. I was timid about going in alone. I was afraid. I could not dare to go into the pool all alone. So I sat on the side of the pool. William Orville Douglas sat on the side of the pool to wait for others. He was waiting for others. Then came a boy. I had not been there long when in came a big bruiser of a boy. Bruiser type of a boy, a boxer type of a boy, a strong built personality. Probably 18 years old. He was probably 18 years of age. He had thick hair on his chest. So this is the description of that particular boy. Strong built, having hair on his chest. He was a beautiful physical specimen. He was a specimen of physique, with legs and arms that showed rippling muscles. His muscles were visible. Rippling muscles, having different design muscles. Rippling muscles. He yelled. As soon as he arrived there, he yelled, shouted, "Hi, Skinny, how do you like to be ducked?" "Hello, Skinny. Hey, skinny boy, weak, thin boy. How do you like to be ducked? How do you like if I throw you into the pool? To be ducked into water, to be drowned into the water?" With that, he picked me up and tossed me into the pool, the deep end. Saying this, he tossed me into the pool, to the deep end. What was the depth of deep end? 9 feet. I landed in a sitting position. When he threw me up, I landed into sitting position, swallowed water. He was merely a child, 10, 11 years old. He swallowed water because he was underwater and went at once to the bottom. As soon as he was thrown into the water, he was there to the bottom. I was frightened. Who was frightened? William Orville Douglas. But not yet frightened. I was frightened, but not yet frightened out of my wits. But not too much, because I remembered the saying of my teacher. On the way down, I planned. What was my plan? When my feet hit the bottom, I would make a big jump. As soon as my feet would touch bottom, I would make a big jump, come to the surface, lie flat on it, and paddle to the edge of the pool. This is taught by the teacher. So what he thought? As soon as he will touch the bottom, he will use his strength to come to the surface, lie flat on it, and paddle to the edge of the pool. It seemed a long way down. Those 9 feet were more like 90. Those 9 feet were more like 90. It seemed that I was 90 feet below water level. And before I touched bottom, my lungs were ready to burst. I had plenty of water. But when my feet hit bottom, I summoned all my strength and made what I thought was a great spring upwards. What was my thinking? To collect your power and try to spring upwards. I imagined I would bob to the surface like a cock. What I thought? I would come out of water. I would come to the surface like a cork. But that did not happen. Instead, I came up slowly. I opened my eyes and saw nothing but water. When I opened my eyes, I saw nothing but water everywhere. What happens then after? For the next day? Thanks for being with me.